IPA.
What's going on, gangsters? Welcome back to the ESL Pro League. One more game to go. It's going to be Overpass, and I'm joined by Yang Ko. Let's go.
Why is it going to be Overpass, Alex?
That's
the question.
Oh, my God. Look at the synergy. He literally knows what question I'm about to ask. It does help that I have pie charts open right now, but yes.
I don't really have a good answer for you. I have no idea why FaZe First didn't veto it in the two maps, because they only played it. I actually had to look it up. They only played it once ever against Dignitas in E-League.
And they lost.
I mean, G2 doesn't really play it that often either, but they played it recently. I remember at the ECS finals against the SK Gaming team and someone else, and I know that they won both times.
I actually have the results in front of me, and the results were very convincing. They have a 16-5 victory versus the Brazilian side SK, current world champions, and then a 16-2 versus Fnatic, and that's the Fnatic of old, the big dogs. So they've dropped 7 rounds in 2 games of Overpass versus 2 of the best teams in the world on this map, and FaZe have played it once and lost versus a Tier 2 Danish seed.
I'm not really sure why they... What they decided to veto, if not Overpass. So,
wow.
But we'll have to see. Obviously, you can assume that now I think that G2 is going to bounce back and take this map.
You know what? The stats definitely do not lie. It's kind of crazy as well, just to see how that slips through. Maybe FaZe, maybe Alu wants to go ahead and make them an Overpass team. I don't know. I'm trying to think of what could possibly have changed. But yeah, so this is a rarity then, when we just sit there and go, G2 are almost like black and white on paper going to win this every single time. There's no, like the stats, what the stats suggest. However, with what we've currently been experiencing, Yanko, watch this FaZe go 16-0 right now.
No, I mean, anything is possible, of course, but G2 should be a big favorite here, simply because Overpass is not one of those maps where you can just, you know, go for a Puggy style and jump onto the map and run around. And, you know, you need to have coordination, cohesion, especially on the T side, to fend off the AWPers, to fend off early aggression, and then have some actual, you know, executes with smokes and everything, so you can get the bomb down and play after that.
Yeah, so what does the typical default for T side on Overpass look like? How do they distribute their resources? How do they distribute the five?
Well, usually players spread out towards the toilet area, long area. You know, you want to get control of toilets and or stairs so that you are able to rotate between the two bomb sites pretty much.
And we'll be seeing if they do implement anything snazzy. This does look like it should go G2's way. They've walked through SK, they've walked through Fnatic on this map in the past 3 months, and FaZe have not. Let's see, though, what they can do. See if FaZe can get another win under their belt after success on cash. Your casters are ready for this one. It's none other than the handsome and deadly duo that is Henry G and Stata Kist.
We are pretty deadly. If you don't open a window in a room that I've been sitting in after I was drinking the night before, it'll kill you.
I can confirm. It definitely is an interesting aroma in the apartment right now.
I wasn't drinking last. I've given that up.
For good?
Yeah, maybe. We'll see.
All right.
Either way,
I support you.
It's God Alu that might bring them something special on Overpass. That's
well,
the thought.
You heard the guys on the desk. The stats do not look good for FaZe going into this one. G2, one of their favorite maps here. And I think, as I said, FaZe have only ever played this map once, and that was at E-League when they lost to Dignitas. So it suggests that they definitely will be bouncing back, and G2 should be taking this one. Pretty convincing, I'd say. I wouldn't be surprised if FaZe don't get to double figures here. So it's a perfect opportunity now for G2 to show us what they can do. I think cash was a little bit disappointing for them. Fantastic for FaZe, considering the run they're having since Alu has joined them, and I think it'll be a good game regardless, but I do, yeah, obviously favor FaZe going forward into this one. We are going to get straight into the pistol, and it's going to be FaZe on the CT side. They've got 5 sets of armor here. Suggest something a little bit more aggressive. They need to be hunting for some early kills here. Can't really allow the bomb to be coming down, and you can see Scream's actually got a Desert Eagle. That's kind of sexy for a T-pistol. What's he got up his sleeve?
Well, it's going to be over toward B, undoubtedly, but the problem is, in not sending anyone A at all and taking their time on this, look where Alu is already.
Yeah, look at the formation of G2. They're all waiting T spawn. We're shocked a little bit more up front as well.
Shooting. Okay, AZ goes down. This is interesting though, because now the timing comes in. Alu can go, and that's some team damage that wasn't necessarily required. His scream, we watch it, fires into the back of his teammate RPK. AZ just has to slow them up in this. Alu, he's just getting toward the monster tunnel just now. Silencer out on AZ. Alu getting there, but still not spotted. They will turn back, give him some attention. No, it's scream just falling back down the ramp and into his hands. But they found some equaling kills. Surprisingly, it's RPK, 2 HP, that's doing the damage required. It's just rain remaining. And it's going to be the USP jumping out the window down toward the site. RPK will fade out of this, and Body just has to stay alive. We talk about this behind that wooden board, so all he has to do is just stay there and pull Rain in. RPK can play off of that alone, and it's exactly what happens.
Really nice round from RPK. Showing some really good form as of late, and that's another three kills for him. It looked like FaZe has that one completely tied up in terms of the positioning, the way they got so much information at the start of the round. You pointed out Ali's position there. He's coming in the back as well. Like G2 just didn't have anything covered there, but all of a sudden, RPK finding three kills and finishing things off as well after the bomb was planted. I mean, G2 did pick up the pistol here, so it's going to be a semi-force by from FaZe. Three players will be going for upgraded pistols and armor as well. Rain and Alu not investing in the armor, just getting Deagle and P250 respectively. Grenades just raining in towards middle. And that's going to be Molotov burning the toes of Rain as well. UMP finishes him off.
That's what you did there.
Yeah.
Raining in, Rain finishes him off. Alu, meanwhile, though, behind the rocks, going to add that if you can't afford armor, just use nature. That's what Alu's thought process is. Scream, though, trying to figure it out toward that fountain position. And as they go around the corner, Body will solve the riddle that is Alu waiting in that position. Pretty straightforward as they continue to work down long, guns in hand, just the pistols of AZ and Kiyoshima left remaining in toward the A site, and Kiyo's actually going to get a little bit aggressive toward the Bathurst, try and catch off RPK, but there's no doing that. The UMP, easy kill, and it's AZ well and truly out of the action over toward the B site.
Yeah, they only managed to pick up one kill this round. It's going to be G2 capitalizing here. Seems to be very efficient in their anti-ecos. Is he picking up a MAC-10? And he's got head armor as well, I guess, at this point with the bomb being planted. He'll just save it for the next round and see if he can cause any sort of damage with it. It's unlikely he can do anything substantial, but if he can pick up a kill, obviously, like we've always said, $600 for an SMG. So that seems to be the logical decision right now. It's going to be just not really hunting super aggressive. You can see RPK is going towards playground. Smith is flashing out towards long. It looks like AZ will survive this one. So it's going to be a 2-0 in favor of G2 on Overpass. As we said, we do heavily favor them coming into this game.
I would agree. I think you have to. Again, the stats can be used to prove anything, all that, yada, yada, good stuff. But really, when they don't play the map at all and G2 is as successful as they have been on this, it's going to be an uphill battle the entire time for FaZe. And, well, it's already starting that way. 2-0 for G2 off the hop, and it's going to be sitting back and waiting it out this round on the CT side. One upgraded. No, I take that back. AZ didn't. It looked like he went to PT50. That overlay still confuses me from time to time. They still look quite similar, but very different.
Very similar, but very different. Anyway, this should be the redundant round we discussed before. It's this USPs across the board, pretty much, popping that aforementioned PT50, and they're going to be stacking towards the toilet area as well. But the problem is, G2 just helped himself to the bomb site undetected. And at this point, that's pretty much round over before any frags have been exchanged. It's not really like the CTs can actually do anything about this. Bomb planted, and what's the play now? We might as well go for something.
Magic.
I guess there is an idea of not giving cash towards G2 by not actually dying. And saving some cash going into their pockets, but they'll just be holding up towards the A side. They don't even want to go towards the other side. They're hoping, shops though. This is actually kind of an interesting idea. Try and take down the hunting terrorists instead of you going and trying to get exit kills, just holding on the other side of the map, hoping they'll come and find you, or they're trying to farm money with their SMGs. RPK does take down Rain, but Jacob, he shuts him down.
Interesting thing about that too is that AZ, now that he's picked up this SMG, if he goes and gets more kills with it, he in turn can farm cash because they've gifted him basically gold in the form of a gun. So there it is, AZ, exactly that. Gets a $600 kill, all in the fact that they found the hunter. So
that's kind of cool as well. That UMP is actually very viable going into this round. He can save money going forward overall. UMPs certainly have a place in the gun rounds as well. It just means you have to play a little bit differently. But you can see Kiyoshima, he's actually just gone for an MP7. He could definitely have afforded a Famous or even an M4, but he's gone for the SMG himself. Has 2K left over, so that's an interesting decision from him. We'll see where he decides to go with this one. It's going to be throwing the smoke over towards Shorts, and it looks like a fast B attack actually coming in from G2. All five players towards this side of the map at the moment. Going to be some wall bangs going in, and Jacob, though, he's getting a little bit aggressive. He could be greeted by a lot of terrorists there.
Jacob has to get away. Does manage to cross back. Oh, wow. How does he miss that? That was dead on, I thought. But either way, Body goes down. Second approach, better trying. Still locked in the corner. Can't push through on the front of G2 right now because FaZe can cover off from sandbags. They just don't have the utility to try and pull him away safely. So Alu still has a lineup potential coming in from the stairwell. Door closed. You can Hodor, but does it really work against Alu in an AWP in that case? A little tin door?
It's all good stuff, man. It's all good stuff.
Is tin really, I mean, Here's a funny story. I once got sent to my room. My mom was home. My dad wasn't there. And I used to be rather... I take advantage of the situation because my mom's pretty small. So I slammed the door so hard. I was like, I'm not going to my room. I slammed the door so hard that it actually slammed and jammed me in my room. My mom was like, well, yes, you are. Got stuck there for about 4 hours. AZ comes back, finds one in the shocks. Screaming Smith, though. They're going to be pulling this right back. Rain does pull back to one-on-one, but Smith is able to walk back through. So surprisingly, when they go on the site, despite that they got the early kills out in the middle of the water position, and it looked like G2 had absolutely no movement with Alu on that AWP, they find the kills going in. Apparently closing the door does work, because Sharks can focus inside the site, and the trades are favorable. G2 pick up the round.
Yeah, coming back in that round after the disadvantage in terms of the manpower. It's going to be G2 finishing things off. Smith's in the one versus one. Actually nails the shot. He's low HP as well, so did a very good job to actually find round number four here. It's actually broken the economy of phase as well going forward. It's got PT-50s, Desert Eagles, and 5.7s. Bit of body armor as well to accompany them. As Shox, he goes hunting once again with a MAC-10 and will be walking his way in towards the B side here. He's the only player on this side of the map here, so he's trying to sell something as his teammates are holding towards middle area. If he can find a nice little kill here from an aggressive... Oh, this is so perfect from Shox. Could he wish for a better scenario? Someone walks into you, has no idea, doesn't even check the tight angle. And he gets to fall back as well. Does take a bit of damage there, but it's... I mean, his teammates can get up towards long. He does go down eventually. Jacob finds the headshot with the 5-7, but Rain up against him now as he faces from toilets.
Alu with the P250. Scream's gonna walk up from long right now, though. Alu will hear this from inside of the bathrooms, but he's got a little bit of problems still. Well, that's gonna actually go away. I was gonna say in the form of Scream that's still in the toilet position. Easy though. Good dink comes through, and that allows Jacob not only to get the kill on the body, he follows it up with a kill on Scream. Alu's been waiting the whole time, but Alu, my goodness. I'll wear the black t-shirt, not the white one after that, as it comes down to a one-on-one, but Jacob still pulls it off, so it works out. There was damage dealt. 5 kills, Jacob, all with pistol as well. That's an incredible ace from him.
What a round. Like he said, I thought that it was over and Alu missed that shot in the back. His RBK to spin around, gets the headshot, but Jacob just holding on the A side, hits absolutely everyone. An ace with a P250. That's pretty nuts. It's the replay right now. Oh, those are the worst ones. You get a horrible feeling in the pit of your stomach when that happens, Matt. I know you felt that plenty of times in your CS career.
What CS career?
All the show matches and 1v1s you do.
Those things that I don't care about?
The big
stage.
How do I
get a pit in my stomach when I'm not emotional about those?
I don't know. Everyone likes to play CS.
Speak for yourself. I like watching it. Because when I play it, I cry every time.
All right, well, what can you say about that one? It's going to be FaZe finding their first round somehow with a PT-50 ace from Jacob.
That's remarkable, to be fair.
If we can get a clip of that at the end of the match, that'd be great.
We'll certainly get a clip of Alu whiffing. I imagine that's certainly already public. But yeah, that ace, it's not common. I mean, we saw Liege do it at the Major. It's not common that you see an eco ace. So well done to him. Speaking of, he's over toward jungle right now. He'll play this off of AZ. They've got Molotovs out toward the barrels. And this is actually to deter them from coming up the ramp. It's a surprising Molotov thrown early from the tees because they've got the information now they're not in that direction yet still continued to check onto it. Regardless, they find the angle lineup. Shox and Smith with kills. Alu, he's flashed slightly, has to retreat his position slightly. Allows the bomb plant to come in and it's HP advantage now for G2 and Smith takes the fight, reads Alu well and Kiyoshima 15 HP. Has no kids. I imagine this is going to be a situation where he likes to get away quite quickly. Just a moment's time, maybe not. He's got the headshot on Smith, so still chance to go through. One flash through. But yeah, I'm imagining.
With no kit as well, I think
really?
This round is over. Yeah.
Okay, good. I was going to say, he's got 15. It's not like he needs to get any much closer with that little time, but.
Well, there it is. It's going to be GT bouncing back after losing to the Pistols. It's not going to be as devastating as you may think for FaZe going forward. Obviously, the round they did win was on an eco, so there is money left over. And with the weapon saved as well, they could force into it. It's not a fantastic situation by any means. You can see they've got about 4K on Rain, 3,300 on AZ, 3.2 on Jacob. So they could buy into it somewhat. And with the M4 saved as well, looks like they will be doing exactly that. So what are they bringing to the table here? We have got a Famous, an M4 shotgun, M4A4. On the hands of Kiyoshima, Alu, and he finally gets an M4 as well, but you can see they are very limited going into this one. Someone's going to have to step up and try and find that first kill, get something going, an option at least, as we enter round number 7. If they were to lose this one, it could mean a double eco going forward, so all on the line on this round.
take him. Shotgun up close. He's the only one not with a rapid-fire rifle. That's what they're called in technical terms, right, Henry?
I think fully automatic is...
Don't correct me.
That's what it's called.
Don't do that.
Anyway.
Yes, dear. I told you in the vows that you had to say yes, dear.
Yes, dear.
Thank you.
Although, do you know Pontus from Twitch? He proposed to me last night.
I'm not surprised. So, redheads, man. They'll do anything.
So I'm just telling you, you need to watch out for that guy.
I'm not that worried. Kiyoshima down at the front of bathroom, slight gap to watch M4. They're going to fall back, go passive inside of this A site. Play it right now off of Alu. Rotation coming in as well from Rain, but I could go either way still. A minute to work with, just under a minute to work with for G2. Long rotations, remember, back to B. So usually you can get, from our perspective with the minimap, a good read early on of which site they're heading towards. In this one, it's quite obviously A. As Smith says, the AWP clearing the angles, not pre-aiming the jump box. Instead, getting a little bit closer to try and find the firepower as the smoke is down at long. Alu and Kyo, though. It's passive setup. It's going to lure them in and be a little bit... false sense of security, I guess you could say. A little bit misleading for G2 as they walk through. Alu finding one, Kyo the other, but they're traded out. That's well done from G2 in that situation, considering the positioning. And again, the trades. They continue to come in, and they continue to favor G2 as the bomb will go down. But watch the flank. It's going to be Jacob, though, that's on it. The unfortunate part of that is he's got a shotgun. Yep. It's so far for him to fire, and he does have a USP, sure, but how much can you really hope to accomplish with that even against the armor?
Yeah, they've got no grenades either, and there's no defuse kits really available. So this is all going to come down to the frags, and AZ coming in towards that bank area. You can see shocked. He's tied himself into the corner, and you can see AZ does somehow find him there. So now it's a 2v1, a real possibility, but his body doing some nice work here. AZ does get the final kill, and it's enough time to defuse as well. So that's a big round for FaZe to pick up, considering the buy they had going into this one. Definitely was a force buy, and it's going to be AZ to finish things off. That shot with the smoke, I'm not really sure how he got the awareness there, but must have just caught something as the smoke was dissipating there. He comes out on top and wins the round four phase as well. Like I said, that would have been a double eco situation if they weren't to win that one. So it's a big round.
And those are the rounds they're going to need, not just the economy, take that away, but the fact that it's overpass, and we mentioned the clutches have to go in their favor. It's going to be such a tall order for them to just make a case out of this. But here we go again. Rain, monster smoke thrown.
That's right.
Point. Oh, you were doubting me for a second.
No, I thought he was positioned somewhere. I thought he was going for the short smoke. I saw the position.
Well, AZ has capitalized upon that smoke as they walk through it blindly, and he's waiting behind the barrels. Three kills for him. Body finding him in turn, but Jacob is there. Shocks. He's going to try with the Tech 9, but Rain silencing that efforts as well. Those efforts. Yeah, English hard.
I thought he was going to hit that second headshot there. Got a bit scary for me there. But so it's going to be the third round for FaZe. Looking like a more of a well-oiled machine, actually getting some rounds put together. It's AZ from the barrels just mowing them down there. And now we do have guns available for G2 after that partial buy in the previous. They've got four AKs at the moment. RPK will be going for the Galil and Flashbang. They are limited in terms of what they can actually bring to the table in terms of grenades and smokes and such like that. They've got one smoke in the hands of body. And it's a difficult prospect actually getting onto the bomb sites on overpass. It's sure you don't really need them to do the full defaults that they are doing now, getting map control. But once you actually execute to the bomb site, it can be very difficult indeed. But there is the first exchange coming in. Kiyoshima taking down Smith's body, finds Rain. And Kiyoshima now continuing the good work he's doing as he finds shocks.
Yeah, well traded off though by RPK. Jacob's going to try and play behind Optimus Prime once more. Good shot on the first, second one. Low HP walks in. Jacob, he's got two. It's just Scream remaining, bomb in his hands, but a minute and 15 seconds. 70 grains left in the hourglass. Watch them tip away slowly. That's something you would do. Lonely and depressive, listening to Morrissey in your room.
Anything else? Is that it?
There's not really much else. It's kind of boring other than that.
Right.
I could talk about the imagery.
Yeah, go on then.
Studded belt on tight, cheap Monday ripped black jeans with a slight acid wash around the knee.
Right.
As the wind whistles by the window and the raindrops crash upon the... Okay, I'm done.
Right. Well, next time, tell me what you really think. Anyway, we're going to be getting into this 3v1 situation. It's going to be Scream, or should I say Screamy. He's feeling creamy as he does make his way towards the A site now. He's going to take a lot of hard work here, and he's getting flashed off, and it looks like the CTs will be aware of his position. AWP in the hands of Alu. Scream has got the bomb. That's pretty much all he's got going for him right now. As he takes his final breath, and makes his way to the site.
Final breath indeed, and it goes down to about the 15-second mark before it did end, but we go back in 5-4, so FaZe starting to accumulate some rounds back in their favor, which is a rather impressive feat considering what we said at the start of the show. Not a map they play often, and G2 have handled the world's best on it many times.
Absolutely. Pretty convincing case so far for FaZe. We have to say, no one really thought they stood a chance against GT. They're about to tie things up at 5-5 after losing the pistol as well. This isn't looking too bad for them at all. This FaZe lineup seems to be full of surprises the last few days. And I think these leagues, like these constant online big games, it's been pretty beneficial to them. They seem to be getting better and better every single evening we see them. Definitely a team to watch the next few months, I think. It's going to be interesting season one LAN especially.
Yeah, that's the biggest thing I'm waiting for, is if they can replicate this in a LAN performance and in that environment. Mm. More so because by the time the LANs come around, the other team should hopefully have cleaned up their act as well. So the challenge will truly be on. Body challenge as well. Deagle shot into the head of Kiyoshima. Open it up with the one taps. That's going to be Rain, though, to pop back out, find Scream, speaking of, and immediately takes him down with the A1S. Smoke out again on Bathrooms. They'll redress that immediately, not give any vision to these pistols at range. Leg shot from Alu. Second one, well, even lower, shoots through the legs of his opposition, but now he goes to the pistol to close it out. He knows he's done the damage. 20 HP left on him, though, and it's a lovely shot from Shox around the corner to find him, but he's the last alive. Getting a bomb plant out of this, not too bad, all things considered, but instead, he's actually going to take the fight. Baits this out, goes to the A1S, back to the Deagle, flash up over, and he has a chance to try and go for this. He sticks with the pistol instead, but he's caught by Jacob as he tries to retreat.
Jacob, one versus one situation against the master of the Shox, and he finds three kills in that eco as well, and makes it a very convincing case to actually try and finish it off, but the flashbang is high, doesn't quite catch Jacob fully, and he's able to catch retreating shocks that he's making his way back towards middle. But 5-5, FaZe have done it. They've tied things up here. They've got the AWP in the hands of Alu. Let's see what he decides to do. We talked about him being more aggressive and confident since he joined his lineup and actually going for the initial picks on the CD side. Let's see if he continues that right now. He goes towards B with that AWP. Actually, we'll be facing towards Monster Tunnel, it seems. And we'll flash off initially, but still, those fancy his chances. On the other side of the map, it's going to be G2 going for the mid control. It's pretty standard stuff so far. As Jan keeps describing the desk, the idea is to kind of get control along the toilets area as well, push the CTs back to the bomb site, and then you can actually start using the smoke grenade, taking the vision away, Molotov in the key positions, and go for that all important bomb plant. That's the idea, anyway. Doesn't normally ever go that smoothly.
The boot, I mean, that boost type, I actually prefer in some ways to the one out in front of bathroom, because you've got a lot more angles that are controllable from your perspective. You're not as vulnerable when you do drop it away, but you still have to get back inside of your site. And if you give up front bathrooms or an AWP gets in that position, one of you is going to be caught or at least have to win a duel. So Smith is exactly that position right now. He brings that AWP out to the front. If they fall off and try and run backwards toward bank, it's quite easy to catch them in this situation, specifically the player that Keo is standing on top of. And there's the shot through. He's able to get by it just barely. That must have grazed a wall as well, because it only took him down to 67. Good response. Alu gets aggressive fast in front with the AWP, but it's Rain again. Three kills on the M4. And Scream, bomb down inside the site. 1v3, tries to find the first shot over top of the dumpster, and Rain's going to turn back, find him as well.
This is looking good from FaZe, actually holding off a full G2 attack onto the bomb site. The problem for me for G2 then, they didn't actually utilize the smoke factor we talked about before, the wall of smokes to segregate the CTs on the bomb site, make them play behind utility before they can actually have confrontation with the terrorists there. They're actually running in with, there's quite a lot of vision available for FaZe, as Alu got full vision with the AWP. You can see it right now on Rain's screen. There's nothing really stopping him apart from that secondary flashbang, but he finds a kill fully blind regardless. It's going to be 6-5 now. FaZe actually take the lead here on the map. Everyone thought they were actually going to drop off on, but we go into round number 12. It was the first map where G2 were played with economic issues. Lots of force buys coming in, never really got rolling with a full buy on the T side especially. They will be at maximum stage loss bonus already. So that's actually 5 rounds in a row now for FaZe. The money isn't quite reflective of that. There have been a lot of close scenarios here with clutches, 1vx moments. So they'll be looking to take this one and hopefully break G2 down so they can start really stabilizing their money. But we'll see what happens in round number 12 here. So it's going to be a PT-15 in the hand of Smiths. No grenades available for him at all. And like a little for body. So far, they have got full control of the bathroom, so you can see there's a boost coming in. Rain's looking over that smoke. He needs to be careful with his right, though. I'm sure his teammates watching it beneath him.
Yep, another boost being shown. It's definitely the map that lends itself to it, but there's that's the problem with it. Yep. You're so in the open as soon as you come around. They're all tradable. That one more so than any in that situation as two players walk out. Alu gonna get forced back here as well, and they've already got the bank stairs covered off. Alu, around the corner, watch this. AWP smoke. Ooh, well, maybe. Inaudible noise from Scream. You can see it lowered, or rather, italicized, not bolded. X-ray, it's not quite got the thick frame around it. Scream's just sitting there waiting. He's still not making any noise, so he's gonna find Alu. No idea that he's there. And although Jacob Last Alive does get one kill, he's gonna have to bail on this round. So G2 will at least pull one back and make it 6-6. But a long first half so far. It's been 12 rounds, but to conclude the 12th, but all of these dragging on to the point where execution is key, and it's been a lot of activity on the A side, oddly enough. Na'Vi is one of the only teams that we typically see go A frequently. It looks like G2 is following in that footstep.
Well then, it's G2 fighting back there. The problem is for FaZe that round, that boost, that all-important boost. It looked like it was going to be very successful in that first pick. The problem is G2 having control of the bathrooms as well. As soon as they call the boosters there, Shox is able to come out and get that double kill and completely lock it down. That opened up the A site. And once the smokes are down as well, the CTs couldn't really retake successfully. Out of this time, changing up his philosophy in round number 13. He's got the auto shotgun, and he's down in the connector area as well. I'm not really sure what it's going to lead to. Maybe one kill before he gets dropped by the following terrorists, but still an interesting idea nonetheless. Three players towards B, four phase as well. Actually left A very exposed. They have no idea if players could be walking up long, so it's going to be a matter of time before they start second guessing and trying to work out what's going on.
Jacob, been looking for that jump. Trying to get the information. But look at this shot from Alu. Body gets the kill onto him instead. Takes the AK back up toward the stairwell. Jacob wants to try and push back out on this. The problem is that as he does this, Kiyoshima's left alone at front bathroom because Rain's doing so passive at long. In doing so, he does allow himself a faster rotation, but he's got AZ alone in B. He's got to do everything. He only manages one kill, and RPK forward stance at jungle is already going to be holding off the rotation.
Four versus two now. It's going to be Kiyoshima rotating back in, and you have to feel like they can't really do much with this round. They're limited in terms of Kiyo. He's just got the auto shotgun, Rain with the M4, no kits, just a couple of flashbangs. They are going to be trying to see if there's any sort of opening here, but you feel like it's going to be surrendered at this stage because they can't really justify trying to go in and find four kills. They'll be saving their weapons for the next round. I think the money suggests it could be on an eco as well. That was definitely a sort of force buy after losing the previous. So this will be two rounds in a row now for G2. Capitalizing towards that B site. This didn't really have much to hold off G2 as they came into that B site. They will be saving the weapons, but for how long? It looks like the hunt has begun, but they'll actually be sticking together towards C spawns. So they'll actually be okay. As we get to round number 14, I'm going to guess they won't force into this one considering this could be last round next and they want to have some money. To finish things off, they have got an M4 in the hands of Rain. Maybe he can go aggressive and towards connector, try and find the first pick and give them something to work with. Smith's back on the AWP as well. Four players heading towards B and Scream is holding middle. And Alu, of course, will be back in the connector area.
Kiyoshima with the shotgun this time. Let's see if he can do better. I would say replicate Alu, but that might be a bad idea. Let's see if he can do a little bit better. He does have a good angle held on this, but Shock slow peek through. He's going to get distracted out, and Jacob, he actually hits the shot, so never mind the shotgun, but it doesn't matter. Kill secured. That's the primary objective, and now the shotgun goes back to bags, but it's smoked off. And even if he wants to rotate, okay, he needs to go now. He needs to go with his teammate, because if he rotates, okay. Alu goes down. Sacrificed himself. The martyr, perhaps. To the thunder-clapping shotgun of Kiyoshima.
He's doing what he can, but he's burning alive and getting more banged as well.
Yeah, so he's gonna have to fade away off this. The problem is he's the last alive. They lose the M4 that was saved over G2. Looking like they're gonna go 8-6, AK grabbed. I don't think Smith can see him, is that what you're asking?
No, he just team-killed body.
I didn't even catch that. That was so out of character that I didn't even see it in the obituary because I was watching Kyo trying to get the AK.
Yeah, it was just random. It was just a headshot onto his teammate. So, okay, see ya.
Okay, rip body. Well, I'm going to watch it on the stream and see if I...
Yeah, to be fair, it doesn't really equate to anything. It's last round, next round anyway, and they've got plenty of cash. But it was just a weird series of events. We go to round number 15. Money's still a little bit limited for FaZe, but they have got five rifles, no kits, no head armor. Obviously not a big deal against the AK-47s and AWP, but they have got those grenades to work with. Five smokes, no incendiaries though. It's looking like G2 may favor another B attack here. It's only all four players towards that screen once again. This guy holding the flanks. They did get a little bit of a surprise towards short last time that ordered shotgun. We have got a little boost going in towards short pipe as well from Rain.
So I just saw it show up again on the Reddit, or on the Reddit. I might go to Reddit, who knows?
On the Twitch,
and Smith was just like hypersensitive on his mouse, I think, watching that tunnel to see if he was gonna go for the AK, and body jumped in the way and he just reacted to it.
Right, okay.
Either way, AZ behind barrels last time he was here. 3 kills he did gather for his team, but a Molotov out when he's blinded. He doesn't even know he's burning yet. He's got to jump forward of the barrels, and that's going to be body to collect him. Not only that, Rain, same thing for him. Body with 2. Smiths gets Jacob, and it looks like 9-6 might be a thing here, but I say that it's only a one-man advantage, and although they have the bomb site, well, the problem is Kiyoshima's taking so long to rotate. He wants to go for this big flank. So Alu really needs to stay alive, stay efficient in this. Spots one player in behind the pillar. Does actually manage to get the kill on the right just to one shocks, but Smiths is there. And now they're going to look toward each other. Don't team kill this time. G2 as FaZe with Kiyoshima walking through Monster.
Back to A.
It's actually a smart call.
Yeah, I think so. They know they can't see Kiyoshima at all right now. He wasn't upper. He wasn't coming from CT spawn. So the logical conclusion would be he's coming from the back, and now they've made their way towards A. He's going to be so far removed from the situation, it's not even funny. He has no kit, he has 1 flashbang, that's it, and 2 players to find as well. He realizes an A-side attack now, so needs to work out what the next portal call is as he starts slowly but surely making his way to A.
Keo.
That's all he's really got to work with here, that's 1 flash.
Yep. 1 single flash does spot Smiths in the open, but no kit. Do it, just run. Run and gun and try and crouch spray, that works. Smiths will get the shot. So 9-6 in favor of G2. Not bad at all for FaZe, and all things considered, they don't really play the map in G2. Well, they do, and they've beaten Fnatic on it, they've beaten SK on it.
Sure.
They've beaten some other good team on it.
Yeah, FaZe, that's actually better than I was expecting. They lost a pistol and still get 6 rounds. That's not bad at all. That's actually pretty decent. They got 5 gun rounds in a row as well. So not the worst half by any means. I was expecting a lot worse considering the stats we have available. But let's see if they can maybe make things a little bit closer. We'll take a quick break before the second half begins. So do not go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Whoa, we were almost perfect. Welcome back. It's your turn to talk.
Is it? That's what you're bringing to the table? That's it. If you just you hit the, wall now.
I don't cook.
You don't cook.
I'll bring alcohol to the table.
I thought you don't drink.
You're right. I'll bring water to the table.
Good. As long as it's still, I don't mind.
Right?
Germany.
I didn't realize going to the bar that the hardest drink to order in the world would be water.
Yep.
I just don't get it right, do they? Well, either way, pistol underway. It's going to be 5 sets of armor on G2 side. A little bit different from FaZe as they had 4. They've lost Rain, though. AZ elects to go for the smokes and flashbangs, but they've lost a member, as I mentioned already, so any utility play they had planned is slowly going to be thwarted and limited, in fact, as they go down to 2 players left with Army. AZ still has that Molotov and whatnot to work with, but this is just impressive stuff. Bomb gets dropped. It's 4 versus 1, and Jacob, he can grab that bomb again inside that water position, but good luck.
Yeah, fantastic work there from the USP of Shocks. Finds headshots all over the place. And Jacob now with the objective to just try and plant that bomb. He can do that. Be a great asset to his team going forward. The 4 versus 1. Pretty much an impossible scenario for him. But if he had got that plant, it does mean they get an extra injection of cash going into the next round. But that wasn't meant to be. And it's going to be G2 shutting it down. A nice bit of aggression there from Short. And we'll see whether FaZe can bounce back here. They'll almost certainly be forcing into the second round here. It'll be Tech9's head armor. Maybe a smoke or two against the P250, but that's about all they really can offer. There will be 1 flashbang. That's it. So 5 Tech Nines. A flashbang. Looks like they're heading towards B. Throw the flash over, Matt. Hope for the best. And let's get in there.
Hope for the best and get in there. That's what I try and do every time I go out. G2, body, going to be firing down through Monster. Smoke goes out a little bit late, but it'll cover off. They haven't pushed through yet. What that does mean is they've wrapped into ward construction instead. And Body's going to try and push through that, but it's RPK instead that will take the aggro on the way through. He'll catch Kiyoshima. Now Rain as well. Body jumps back, and RPK, well, it doesn't matter. He'll steal that kill. Eventually dies, but Smith gets Jacob and closes the round. G2's going to go up to 11, and now I think we might just see them start to run with this game.
Yeah, they're on the favored side now. The CT side of Overpass is where the top teams really will start digging their heels in. You can see Shocks, another stellar performance for him, 16 kills. And we're going to round number 3 here. This is the redundant round. This is where they have nothing to really to work with at all. They can get a bomb down. That's pretty much a success in my book. But to stick together, rush towards mid. Let's see what happens here as Smith does spot them. Decent grenade goes. I'm not sure how much damage he'll do. Not too much, but let's see if the crossfire works out as we have the screen waiting in the connector area as well. Tap, 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 aroo.
Smith's shots through. Get the assist on AZ as a result of that tech. Now, it would have been nice if he could have picked up the kill with it, bring out the AWP a little bit sooner, but they've got money building up, and he's at 7450 regardless on the MP9, so.
This is the real bonus round here, Matt. MP7, 2 MP9s, and a UMP. One
That's
rifle in the first game round.
That's 4 SMGs, yeah. How aggressive did they go?
They have to go super aggressive. They have to just go nuts.
They upgraded one. They did upgrade one. Shocks.
That's probably a good idea. But I'd say maybe and an AWP as well. All right, they've checked with them away. So just 2 SMGs, not as nuts.
Yeah, that would have been. I would have. Hey, look, I'm for it.
So we're all in. You're ready.
It was big for a while. The thing is that it like was a flash in the pan in the meta, and people kind of get used to it. So they play these passive positions like we're seeing now, as Alu's doing, getting ready for these SMGs. But obviously, teams have shied away from it as a result. So they'll leave a few in the map or in the weapon pool. Sorry, not the map pool. Overpass in the map pool in my mind. We're just drones repeating the same words over and over again, and my mind gets confused. But Kiyoshima is going to walk out toward this direction. So if Scream can find this kill, all things considered, great. $600 for him. If he doesn't, the AWP setup from Shocks, or rather Smiths, as Rushley just showed us, is in a prime position, but the AWP misses. AZ one taps him, and Kiyo takes out Scream. That's massive.
We've got the long control now. They're actually making their way to the side very quickly indeed. There's no CT presence there whatsoever. So this should be a time for FaZe to capitalize here and pick up this first gun round. Taking a good position towards Bank as well. Looking to get a rotating player towards Optimus, but he's actually made it. This could be Shocks. He gets the first headshot as well. Drops a bomb. Jacob does find him. It's going to be a 3-on-2 now. Bomb yet to be planted.
RPK tries to smoke himself a little bit further in the side, take advantage of this, but he's still stuck up on that dumpster, and he gets dumpstered as he gets dropped in by Kiyoshima. Jacob gets the trade on body immediately as they come up the stairs. So FaZe pick up the round, all right, first gun round, all considered, not too bad, but they lose 3 in the process. They'll have to buy those back up. They'll drop over an AK to do it, but they've still got money on this G2 side, despite the reinvestment.
12-7. G2 now. Stronger advisor was before. There's the AWP, though. It does come out, so he said that Smith to get railed in that first gun round. Let's see if he can go one better and actually find a kill. Should pick around for them to pick up. It's definitely an eco if they don't win this one, so this would be a great chance to get back into this. We finished the second map off. If you're just joining us, the first map did go in favor of FaZe, actually, on cash. It was a very good performance from them, and we'll see whether they can find the 2-0. It's going to take a lot of work here on the terror side of Overpass, a map they do not play I think they said they played it once since FaZe had been formed in an official capacity. And we get a FaZe towards the bar from the area. Going to be facing Scream. They actually do get the first kill. It's going to be FaZe. AZ taking down Scream, but an equal exchange for now. 3v3 is out. He gets the kill on towards Shox.
Kiyoshima backing away with that AK-47. They still have to find this AWP from Smiths out at long, and identifying the fact that it's there, they're going to just ignore it altogether and head over toward B. So the rotation has to be swift from RPK. He'll play in the window instead, try and get some vision on the way through. Three smokes, though. That's actually enough to cover off the B side, especially if they wanted to put one in toward that window. But the slow peek in, I'm surprised Body doesn't hit that shot. Rain, he hits it, and suddenly RPK's got to go more passive. He elects to rotate into the site itself. Does find one on the way through. But he still has such a long time to wait before the rotation arrives, and he's gone down to 15 HP. Smith just barely missing out. What a shot
again
from Kiyoshima. Just absolutely obliterates, and that's twice he's been taken down from a single bullet of an AK.
Yeah, rough day in the office to be an AWPer, apparently, of your Smiths. Got completely railed towards long in the previous round. This time it's Kiyoshima just schooling him from the bombs on B. 12-8, and that's actually been an EQ now, 4G2. So FaZe, it seems they've been unsuccessful on both pistols of this map so far, but still posting rounds when it really matters. That's going to be two in a row for them now. And finally broken the economy of G2 at the same time. So this could be the P250s and 5.7s. Shox has got a Deagon body armor. And you see Jacob, he will be trying to farm some cash with the UMP. A lighter investment for him. No real stack here for the CTs, but they have made their way toward the connector, but they are being punished for it as well at the same time. Alu, Jacob chiming in together. Two kills with that UMP means $1,200. Just Scream and body remain.
Neither of them remain now, Henry.
It's true. They have gone down. Well,
Shox goes immediately back onto the AWP. So they've actually done well.
Is he throwing that to Smiths, though?
I think he has the spawn.
As Smith said, the guys, I don't want to do it.
I think Shox is. Oh, no, he doesn't. He's at the back. I thought he was the one at the front.
Oh, yeah, he can go towards Monster with that, to be fair.
We could have.
Or push off short. But yeah, bit of a block there. Shox will be facing towards that monster tunnel, but that will be a far clear response as well, as Jacob finds two kills with the UMP there. Molotov's onto the side as well. They won't be stopping at any moment now, as Shox is going to be finding the kill on towards Jacob. Still a 3-on-3, and it's down to Shox. He's waiting for teammates to rotate in.
Shox is going to try and get aggressive with this AWP. He's gone through the smoke. Rain's lost track of him, but does hear him, and he's got the better positioning with the M4 and is able to retreat and turn and find the kill. It is going to be Smith doing exactly that. The first part, at least, the former retreating. He'll run away and try and go back toward A, but oddly enough, FaZe is doing the same thing, so we're going to potentially collide again. Still a minute to work with for FaZe, though. They can try and slow this down once they get up toward the bathrooms, and I highly anticipate that's what they will do.
I would say so. You see Smith's. He has anticipated this quite nicely. He's on the A site right now. He's going to face towards middle, and that could be his demise here as they do spot him. He does a little bit of damage, and now back to B they go. The mind games begin. Where are they really going to end up?
Kiyoshima. Smith's good shot over the first one. Does find it from window. Kiyoshima, though, he's the one that hit the one tap last time. Down to 22 as he gets tagged through the boards and 26 seconds. He doesn't have to commit to the plant just yet. He expects to push through smoke. Just watches out for it. He will plant now, but that's going to give Smith the indication, okay, he's still on the site. So there's really only two angles I have to watch, one of them being that, and Kiyoshima again prevails.
The white face with 22 HP. It was a bold move, but it works out. And it's another round posted for FaZe in terms of gun rounds as well. It's fantastic for him. And it's going to be four in a row. Kiyoshima, 12 kills. Jacob, though, he's the one lighting up the scoreboard, 23 kills. And we go into round number 8 here on the second half. It's actually going to be another eco 4G2. So FaZe once again closing the gap. Could they actually take this second map, Matt? I didn't think there'd be any chance. I even speculated at the start. I didn't think they'd get to double figures. But I think a very convincing case of winning all their clutches. This great individual play and some nice teamwork on the CT side as well. It's been a pretty impressive performance from FaZe as a whole. You can see Alu, he's got the MAC-10, the reconnaissance play. Throw him into the bomb sites first, and he can call for the stacks. It'd be rain to open things up, though. He finds the kill on towards body.
Now lose positioning in this. Just waiting in bathrooms. May find Smith coming up the stairwell, but as the smoke fades, no one pushes through. He's going to elect to try and clear it out instead, heading toward long range. Same thing over toward Monster as he crouches across and waits for anyone toward the bottom of Squeaky. And this is working out. FaZe is slow play. G2, I thought clear cut. They had the momentum and we were on their side, but maybe I've cursed them because now it's going to be 12-11. And Smiths will fall after getting one quick kill onto Alu. Scream, Deagle in hand, 1v4, writing on the wall.
Scream, back of B. Hoping.
Do they have names yet? I wonder if anyone in CS has named these guys.
What, the little monsters?
Yeah.
I don't think they bothered, no. I doubt it.
One of them looks like Moses.
Which one?
Well, there was one that had spikes on his head. Obviously not him, because he has hair.
This one?
Go around. I think it's the green. That one.
That guy.
That one. Yeah, the big round head. You've got on your screen. Rushley will show us eventually if we get an opportunity.
Okay. Well, FaZe do find another round. 12-11, Matt. This is turning into be quite an interesting game. I'm not really sure which way it's going to go. This round will be very defining indeed. If FaZe can bring it into 12-12, then I have every chance to actually go across the finish line as well and continue their great form. They've got in pretty great now. Actually, 5-1, dropping a single map so far.
Smiths is trying to find the angle required to get the opening pick. And we got toward Playground that he looks. Birthday party. Scream. Top of the flower pot. Gonna try and look out front bathroom and watch above that little slanted wall in case anyone does walk back from the lower stairwell. But no one's done so. In fact, they've gone around the fountain to get in the positions in the front of bathroom. And Smith has to hit these shots. He hasn't found one yet with the AWP. It's been an AK to prevail both times. So sometime soon, he surely has to land one of these.
Yeah, he's having a difficult time with the AWP for sure.
He's clearing it as well. So we'll go with the pace of the game. It'll pick up shortly because 40 seconds remains. And they've got to get toward the bomb site. Bomb site likely to be B in this case, despite a very fanned out position from the opposition. Everyone across the map, but Alu is taking bomb that direction in 30 seconds. It's going to have to go.
Yeah, with this time, they have to come in now. But they do have the utility here lined up. They can do the Molotovs towards the barrels of smoke on the bomb site here, but it's going to come down to Body, who's actually playing in front of the utility himself. Up to get boosted up, looking at his initial kills, and can't land a shot. That's finally find Kiyoshima. Rain and Jacob find 3 kills in total, and actually leave it in a 4-on-2 now. Shocks desperately trying to make the retake happen, but Rain feeds him to the punch there. And so he Scream, the last player remaining, but making a convincing case of this. He gets the first 2 kills, 2v1 now, but he only has 22 HP. I'm making 4 now. Did he just lose that as he dropped down?
I think he did on the way through. Either way, he was on the 20, he's on the 4. That's all that matters, Henry. And the tap to pull them through. Flash comes in. Alu, that's even more clever. Why even go when you've got the flames? Especially when he's on 4 HP. It would have killed him in one tick. Jacob finds the kill regardless. 12-12 FaZe. I'm impressed. I really am.
Yeah. This is where G2 sometimes struggle. It's the economic game. They will never take an eco, it seems. If they've got enough just to get 5 rifles, not even that in this case, they'll always go for it. So this time it's going to be Famuses, M4s, no kits, limited utility, and Smith just on that 5-7. So they could have taken an eco and actually had a really strong buy going forward and had everything they needed, but this is still viable, of course. It's enough to win a round for sure, but it's very rare you'll see G2 not buying up in these sort of situations. How many rounds is that around? 6 in a row now for FaZe. What a result this would be if they could manage to take the second map overpass, something they've played once in official capacity before.
That's remarkable that you've been a team this long and you've played a map once in an official.
I don't know the time span on that is, whether it's just FaZe, since they joined FaZe as an org, or whether it was keeping track of the G2's
Anko
days.
That did it. Regardless, yeah. It goes to show you that if you're picking and banning against these guys, you know they're going to ban overpass. That's their auto default ban. So, like, what you can throw a curveball in on that. You could take Nuke into these guys, for example, or something along those lines.
Why wouldn't they veto this map? I guess this is for a reason why. They obviously have been working on it. They're happy to play it now, maybe.
Yeah, well, it would certainly change their ability in vetoes to be a little bit more dynamic, to perhaps veto against that. Their opposition, which who they are playing. Screams are caught. There's no way he's going to get away with that as the gap of the smoke shows. And as they walk in, it's easy to find 2 quick ones. RPK rotating around. Doesn't matter. He's late and he's aggressive. He doesn't wait for body. And 1v5 body's going to try and save the FAMAS, which is a French rifle, actually, oddly enough. So a little note for you. It's what I do recall them having other military when I was there back in 2009. I haven't been in France since then, believe it or not. There hasn't just been that much esports there, and I haven't gone the DreamHack Tour.
Yeah, I don't think we've ever done an event in France, have we? No, we must have done.
Nope.
Hmm.
You might have done, you did DreamHack Tour, didn't you?
Nope.
Last year? No. Okay.
No.
Well, FaZe is going to take the lead.
Absolutely. This is pretty exciting now. That was a force fight from G2, as I said. They were definitely up against it. Needed to step up. Someone needed to find that first aggressive kill just to give them something to work with there. But it was actually Smith's to fight, so it went down first. It was a nice, it's pretty standard approach from FaZe, just working together, hitting all their shots. And now, oh, G2, you're in a world of pain right now. You only get the $3,400. You have saved the Famous. Is that going to tempt you once again to force fight? Are you going to finally take an ego here? We'll see what they decide to do. 4 seconds remaining before 3. So I thought they would take a pause in this scenario, but looks like they will just be going for the full eco. Oh, no. Oh, there is something coming in. Okay, so they got the body armor, last minute, some upgraded pistols as well. So that's fine. That's just called a partial buy. It means they get $3,400 into the next round. They will definitely have enough to buy then, but just wanted to take a bit extra to see what they could do and to accompany the Famas they picked up, which I believe is called the Clarion as well.
Yes, back in 1.6 or Source Days? 1.6.
Yeah, it's always Clarion. Been referred to as the Famas, though. I've never heard anyone
use that. Yeah, me neither. Some guy he's cast with. It was, yeah. He loved to try and meme as much as he could. It's kind of annoying at times. RPK, try and push through. He's got a P250 in hand. His heads toward T-spawn. Rain hears them coming and fears the elephant footsteps.
Okay.
Little does he need to as he hits two headshots lovely against RPK and Shox. There was a third member heading that direction. They've since gone away.
Do you see that panic from the player coming into the pistol as well? We know exactly what it is. Let's get him. That pretty creative flashbang from Rain as well. He just starts spamming his P250 in pure panic.
Yep.
And it all goes wrong from that point as well. Smith's facing towards the monster tunnel. Does get taken down to 17 HP. Rain just completely lighting up the scoreboard at the moment. 3 kills from this round. And it's going to be FaZe taking. This is pretty much a similar scene to what we saw in Cash. Like, G2 got that early advantage and they had it for the majority of the game. Just the closing sectors. FaZe actually took the lead and they closed out the second half pretty convincingly at the end. And that's going to be another 5-1. Screen, just the deagle in hand. Got some body armor, I'd say, at this point. It's not even worth hunting. Like, what are you going to get out of this? It's just going to hope someone runs into his crossing and an AK out of this, but it looks like FaZe, they know the money's going to be tight for GT going forward. If anything, they probably just don't want to risk it. They'd probably say, let's let them save. It's fine. Don't give him risk the possibility of him taking an AK to the next round. They are slightly hunting towards long eight. There's one player there. They're checking out the bathrooms as well. Not really going for a full hunt. But 14-12 now, as we do see the money come back into fruition for G2 here. $3,400 here. Let's have a look at Smith's money. He's got 7.3K. This is it now. They really need to step up here. Don't have a chance of closing this one out. Time dwindling away as we reach round number 12 of the second half. All back in Smith's hand. You have to say, Matt, he's been very quiet in terms of opening picks in the second half. He's just been outgunned most of the time in terms of the rounds that really matter.
Yeah, he's been wrecked. Look at that money on the FaZe side.
Money, money, baby.
Damn. I want that much money.
You're the richest man in esports, I have.
I wish. I certainly am not a holding company that owns 70% of everything in every league.
All right. Okay. Thanks for clearing that up.
Yeah, you're welcome. I wish I was the richest man in esports. You could call me LP Coin then. But it's going to be a Scream walking back in toward bathroom. Crossfire set with Shox. Desperation as they get aggressive. But what is that? They walk in, flash perfectly. Don't even consider the off chance. Two members look the same way. If you're entering in, you've got to cover the angle as the second man that the first does not. And they both walk in and get taken down.
Yeah, strange turn of events there. That's an interesting one for Shox to actually pick up 2 kills. Yeah, they're definitely not out of the round just yet. FaZe is Ali waiting for Smith to face once again. Smith drops, but it's a nice refract from Scream there. Knows he had to do something to recover the situation. He does manage to give him the man advantage once again. 3 versus 2 now, 50 seconds remaining. We'll see what the other two terrorists are up to here. Rain making his way towards Long and Kiyoshima, just lurking in the bathroom area. They still have the smokes available as well, along with flashbang, so still plenty of promise for them to actually do something with this, considering they have 40 seconds.
Either way, it's Scream. That's gonna try and hold this down on the A set while the other two rotate. Both jungle already on B, but they're gonna have to come back eventually. Scream. Jumping a lot will give away his position, but he needs to get this information early. Nearly catches Rain out in the open, but the shot comes back the other way, and they've got an open bomb site now to work with.
Yeah, smoking off towards bank as well. The rotation comes in, RPK and Body. Two men chosen to try and make this clutch work out for G2. This will be match point obtained by FaZe if they can do this one.
And it would be another miraculous evening for FaZe if they could go 2-0 here. It would be one loss, only to Envy so far. And they're already would be up at that point to 7-1. I mean, that's the majority of their season done. They've had a lot of early games scheduled. A lot of other teams scheduling later matches. And Rain, he's going to do it. Two quick kills, covers it off perfectly. And these guys are on an absolute tear right now as a team, FaZe, as they hit 15. They're doing so much work early on in the season that unless they tremendously fall off, it's going to be hard to catch them.
Yeah,
For the top four spots, yeah, sure. I'm not calling it done, but this early on, we know how competitive the league is. This is an incredible start from FaZe.
Yeah, I don't think anyone saw this coming. We were quite used to FaZe being quite a mediocre team in terms of like they're always just about in the top 10, maybe outside it, but they've got good players, but they never seem to come together as a team. That's what we always talk about in the analyst desk and stuff like that, but this is a completely different complexion of the FaZe lineup. Actually looking very promising since the addition of Alu. This is very interesting, considering all the storylines of the previous lineups. But here we go then. One round away from FaZe taking second map here, but Smith's has got other ideas. He gets the first headshot with a scout. He's been poor with the orb. Can he rectify the missed shots with this scout?
Well, he's going to try and flash and get another peek. Just misses them getting in behind the rock as they know exactly where they are. They will not leave themselves exposed, but Smith hits easy. Now he's definitely flying. Oh, he's got the lineup. He nearly does pick it. Goes for the jump instead, and Alu will turn it around finally, but it's down to the 3v3. A push out from Shock's not going to be rewarding, and FaZe, they'll take the man advantage, and they'll take that over toward B. 50 seconds to work with his body. He's inside of the site, but he's not with RPK, who stays on A to get the information. And the interesting thing is he's going in toward bathrooms. Does he try and go for a flank early on, does Body, because, or excuse me, RPK? Because if he does, he could try and thwart them. Body, though, that's too far out. And Keo, again, I have to say you're right. You say his name, and that's accurate. His headshot.
Yeah.
And one-tap entrances have been pretty miraculous, but RPK is going to try the flank.
Yeah, this has been really impressive performance, and they've actually done it by the looks of things. The final kill comes in. It's Keo to finish things off. FaZe take map number 2, Overpass. A map we thought there'd be no chance of them actually taking it against G2, one of their most famed maps in terms of the results they've had on it. And FaZe, 2-0. Don't think you saw that coming back, did you?
Not on this map, no. I definitely knew that the way they've been playing, I'm not going to discount them in any game, but on Overpass, no, I definitely did not. And I have to say, individually, we're talking about the team game, they look sharp as a team, but individually, they're looking really good right now. Alu getting aggressive, Keo hitting every shot, Rain.
Jacob as well. He was top bragging. He was fantastic in that series. Really, really good games tonight. And
Imagine AZ hits like Clues levels.
Yeah, like he's definitely got the potential to do that. Like if they all start firing at their absolute peak, like they're going to be a really scary team going forward. They actually have got the fundamentals together now, and they're looking like a proper team. A map they didn't even play before the previous lineup. They come together with Alu for 1 week, and they're beating world-beating teams on their best maps. So that's pretty interesting.
And the struggles of Astralis, there's lots of teams. Envious beat them, oddly enough, which is one of the struggling teams, but they're taking advantage at all the right times.
Well then, let's throw it over to the desk and see what Yanko and Alex think about
it. The desk is that way, that's why I did that.
Yeah.
FaZe up, bruv. That's happened. It has happened. FaZe have blown everything that we thought we knew. Screw using statistics. Screw looking at past results, because it all means absolutely nothing, evidently, Yanko. Just to reiterate the points we made in the pre-show. Did you hear that? I thought that was a fire alarm. It was Sadakis yawning. Oh! Okay, we're not going to burn Dev just yet. What I was trying to say was they had picked up very convincing results versus the Brazilian side, SK and Fnatic, in the past 3 months. And then we look at this FaZe performance where they basically got one loss in their recorded history of the team, Yanko. Where did this come from?
I don't think this had much to do with the map itself. I think it's pretty obvious from the games we've seen from G2 so far in Pro League that they just can't win rounds on their CT side as of yet. I mean, even yesterday against Na'Vi, the problem was the CT side. I think it was Dust2 where they had an 11-4 half on the T side, couldn't close it out on the CT side. And I think that's more than anything else, that's due to the vacation that the players are still, you know, getting their groove back, so to speak, because, I mean, being a team, playing against a team like FaZe who doesn't play the map, we were talking about how Overpass is more difficult than, let's say, Dust2 or Mirage to play on your T side, yeah. right? And not being able to defend one gun round, I mean, that tells a lot about your current form.
Yeah, I mean, current form for G2, admittedly, is something that we can hail critique and critique for as long as we need to. It's just, I think, I want to run with the FaZe thread and just actually just give some credit where it is due, that this has been a very, admittedly, outside the Pro League, they may have been having their ups and downs, but it's been all up here in the Pro League. I mean, a spectacular performance from them. And I think the point that they made so perfectly was that, you know, finally, more than one person shows up. I mean, that was a problem for a long time, wasn't it, with FaZe, Janko? It was always taking it in turns, somebody who has a great performance and carries them over the line.
Yeah, on Overpass, it was the Norwegians, Jacob and Rain, were leading the way for the team. And they won a lot of, I mean, rounds, even towards the end of the game, where they were, you know, 3v4, 2v4, 3v5, where they started off at a disadvantage and they were still able to bring it back because of their own good individual performance. But also at times, it seemed like G2 was lagging, so to speak, right? They would be maybe too late to retreat and to just play safe and to buy time for themselves. They were overextending a little bit, unnecessarily, you know, reckless, a bit of undisciplined Counter-Strike at times. But I guess it's what you can expect being so short after the holiday season.
Yeah, I think people are still kind of getting to grips with playing CS again. There's no doubt about this. This has been the opening week of the ESL Pro League, and it's about to come to an end. Let's recap, though, how our final day of the first week of the fourth season of the ESL Pro League did play out. We got to see Team X, and Team X basically had a bit of a up and down affair. The new game was one that we will happily forget after seeing such a heavy lead for the Danes. They were unable to close it out on their CT side. Then we did dive into Copper, where we were reminded of what they are capable of, a 16-6 result versus the Razors of Hell. Second games involved the Astralis Navi game. And I mean, I can't help but feel that Astralis are going to be incredibly disappointed coming in again with the Pro League and another two losses under their belt, Janko.
Yes, well, you know, their slogan is to the stars. Maybe they just got a little bit too close to the sun, Alex, and they got burned.
Ooh, going for the Icarus 5, I like it. Then following that, if you did just join us, you saw G2 have a trouble with 12, it seems to be the number they get stuck on, as it's happened again. This time it was versus FaZe in both maps. It happened to them versus Na'Vi as well, but it was FaZe who did thrive, and now you can see what's coming up in North America as well. Europe is done, but North America has got treats for you to look forward to, some delights of Counter-Strike. Of course, this evening we will be seeing Selfless and Immortals play. Alongside that, you get to see what Echo Fox are capable of as well. And the boys from Cloud9 are
going to be showing. I have no idea whose logo is that. I had to think for a couple of seconds as well. I was like, what is this? Then I remember something like E United.
But I knew that.
That's
what are you
team
talking about?
That's made it through.
I knew
well.
That, Janko. You have no idea. You can't prove that. Anyway, Optic and Cloud9 as well going to be meeting, so that will be a good one, a good game to have a look at. If you want to know what the second week's going to look like, we can tell you how our debut day will be. This is going to be happening on Tuesday, so you have a day off. You have a day's rest from us, in particular Sadokist, and you'll be seeing now you get Fnatic and Mouse Sports to kick things off. You get your Nip and Dignitas. That's going to be their debut in the league, of course, for the Danes. And we get to see the new Fnatic roster, Janko. That's probably going to be a highlight for me.
Yeah, definitely. And also Mouse Sports, we get to see them for the first time in Pro League. We'll see in what lineup they're going to show up. That's going to be interesting to see.
That's true.
And we also have off stream, we have NVS versus G2, the French matchup.
Yeah, I'm sure that's always means a little extra, something a bit spicy for Keo. There's no doubt about it. But our first week done and dusted.
He's playing for FaZe, but never mind.
Yeah, okay, fine. All right, whatever. You could have just let me have that one.
I know,
it's been a long week.
I just
week.
Remember Barcelona and
you said it would happen again. Right, we're going to get out of here. Let's go ahead and say our goodbyes, because the first week of the ESL Pro League has been an absolute pleasure. We're going to be back, though, at the same time on Tuesday, bringing you all the more fantastic Counter-Strike. Thank you so much for joining us, and we'll see you then.
I'm sorry.